Welcome to BeerandIron.com's Low and Slow Basic Beef, Pork, Lamb, or Wild Meat Roast Recipe. First thing you want to do is preheat that 5-quart cast iron Dutch oven. You can use a 7 or a 9 depending on the size of your roast. We're using a fairly small roast here, so we're only going to use our 5-quart Dutch oven. This roast has already been brined in a nice beer brine for the last 3 to 4 days. When you pull the raw roast out of the brine, be sure to pat it dry with a paper towel. The spices on that roast are some of the spices we had in that brine, but we're going to keep this particular recipe pretty simple. We do have a recipe for brining meat, if you'd like to refer to that to the website. You don't have to dry it off completely. A little moisture is A-OK. You just don't want excessive moisture on this roast before we get ready to sear it. We've had this roast sitting out for a bit of time to warm up to room temperature, but it's never ever going to get up to room temperature. Don't expect it to get up to room temperature. You just want it to warm up a little bit. Resting at room temperature is always a good thing, though that particular bit of advice will be debated. But you're going to get no argument from me, friend. To each his own when it comes to cooking a good roast. Think of this roast, though round, as a square, as a box. You've got 6 sides that need searing. Sometimes you'll have roasts that only need 3 sides or 4 sides, but this one's going to need all 6 sides. We tend to apply the oil directly to the roast. Some folks would put that oil in that hot Dutch oven, and both methods work just fine. The main suggestion here is not to put too much oil on that roast. You want that roast to sear and not fry. If you have too much oil, it'll end up frying and it'll take a very long time to get a good crust sear. We end up using this roast recipe as an ingredient to many of our other recipes. And tonight, what we're having are po' boy sandwiches. I tell you what, we're looking forward to them. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put these rolls in that hot oven and I'm going to let them cook while I sear this here roast. Now, when I'm searing a piece of meat on the stovetop, I tend to get myself a nice apron on because you're going to splatter and splat all kinds of oil everywhere. I use wooden spoons and wooden spatulas in my searing process so I can use them to position my roast on that hot Dutch oven surface to make sure that I'm going to sear all 6 sides. Because of the potential splatter, I go ahead and throw a towel down on the floor. That splatter intends to happen whether you like it or not. I use welding gloves. That cast iron is wicked hot. Hot cast iron looks just like cold cast iron. Pull that cast iron Dutch oven out of that preheated oven, and when you pull that lid off, the oil that's inside that Dutch oven, that seasoning, is already going to give off a whiff of smoke. Look at that. You better go ahead and crank up that over the stovetop vent hood and keep that number on high, because we about to smoke it up, baby. I tell you what, your fire alarms may go off, so be prepared for that. You want to sear each side of this roast for about 2 to 4 minutes each side. Considering this roast has 6 sides, as we've talked about earlier, this searing process can take about 25 to 30 minutes. One of these laser temperature checkers is completely optional and actually really not necessary for this process. I'm just using it to kind of show you how hot that Dutch oven is getting. You'll find that the first side that you sear is not always seared as well as you'd like it to be seared. And often I'll sear all the sides and then return the side that I'm not completely happy with and give another sear to that particular side that's already been seared. Grab that roast with those 2 wooden handles, flip it over. Look at that. That's a nice sear right there, friends, I tell you what. Now here we are laying it on its side, one of the 6 sides. Look at it sizzle down there at the bottom. And that smoke is heading out toward our vent hood. It's not heading out in the house. But inevitably, some of that smoke will make it out into your home. And when it does, be prepared for them fire alarms to go off. Now you can see this roast has got a string tied around it. It's been trussed. This was trussed from the butcher. and that's A-okay, then strings will hold up just fine during the searing process. You want to just keep turning that roast and searing all six sides until all six sides are seared good. And if you have a question as far as how good, friend, that's completely up to you. This searing process is actually an optional process. You'll see there in the bottom of that pot, you'll see some bits and pieces of parts of that roast that have broke off during the searing process. That's called the fond, F-O-N-D. And if you want to, you can always add an onion to the bottom of that cast iron Dutch oven when you're done searing the roast, and you can saute that onion in order to deglaze that cast iron Dutch oven bottom, gathering up all that flavor. We're not going to do that in this recipe. We're simply going to sear this roast, and we're going to put it on a trivet and stick it in the oven for the foreseeable future. Once all six sides are seared and you're happy with the way it looks, and this roast here in this part of the video is about what it needs to look like, we get our trivets together. Now I'm going to say something about trivets. This is completely optional. There's no rule saying you have to keep a trivet underneath that roast, but we use a trivet. As a matter of fact, I use two of them. Be sure to use one that is meant to be used inside the Dutch oven and not meant to sit on the outside to keep the Dutch oven off non-heat safe surfaces. A lot of trivets have these little rubber parts on the legs. Definitely don't use that inside this Dutch oven. I'm checking that lid now to make sure it's not too hot. It's been sitting out for about 30 minutes near that hot pot, so it's not going to be cool. It may not be cool enough to touch with your fingers. But we're going to flip it over because we need to pull that roast out to put those trivets in the bottom of that pot. Look at that sear. It looks beautiful. All the sides nice and crisp. Perfect. It's raw as can be on the inside. I guarantee that. Pull that roast over. Put it on top of that lid. Now grab your trivets and just set them down in the bottom. Watch your fingers now. Perfect. We set the other one in there, we double decker, but that part's optional. One trivet if that's all you got, two if you got them, and then set that roast right there on the top of those trivets. Friend, we just about done cooking. Do you see that air space all the way around that roast? This roast will shrink a bit as we cook it, and you're going to see that at the end. But you don't want too much air around your roast, but you don't want not enough. If you got a roast too big, use a bigger pot. You don't want the roast touching the edge of the pot or the lid. You want some room. Put a little spin on the lid, make sure it didn't grab the roast. You got that oven turned down to 200 degrees. Don't forget that part. If you leave it at 450, you're going to ruin it. But in the meantime, we've had them rolls cooking. Go ahead and set that cast iron Dutch oven with that roast inside. Looking forward to some po' boys tonight. We're going to let them dudes sit over while we let that roast do its thing. Look at that. If you do have the capability of cooking both of these at the same time, more power to you. We've only got the one oven. Hours later, I'm talking about 4, 5, 6, 7, and as long as 12 hours later, your roast is going to be ready. Usually, you can get by with a good 4 to 6 hours, no worries. Plan on at least 3 to 4. Don't go any shorter. When the time has come, get your gloves on and let's pull out that cast iron Dutch oven. Now you're ready for presentation. Let's see what we got. This roast has been in that oven for about 5 hours. Look at here. Here we go. Oh my gracious, look at there. Do you see the roast itself? Still has that seared look, that roasted look. It also shrank, and you see in the bottom of that Dutch oven, that liquid, that moisture that's down there. Beautiful. That's exactly what we want, and tonight I'm going to make a gravy out of that roast for those po' boy sandwiches. Now, for presentation purposes, I'm going to pull this roast out of the pot, and I'm going to set it on this here piece of wood. But for the most part, all you really have to do is grab yourself a fork and stick it into that roast. If it goes in nice and easy and flakes apart, you got yourself a done roast. You're ready to go. If the fork shows some resistance, cover that pot up quickly, throw it back in the oven for another hour. Now, like I said, a lot of the times we'll cook a roast and we'll have that pulled beef, pork, lamb, or even wild meat all ready to go for future recipes. And what we're doing here tonight is having ourselves some beef po' boys, I tell you what, on homemade rolls. Looking forward to it. We've got some delicious gravy that we've made from the brine and fat that roast produced for us tonight. And we're about to eat like kings, indeed. We're about to eat like kings. Now, I made that gravy inside that pot, same Dutch oven I cooked that roast in. The reason I'm showing you this little bit here of these sandwiches is because, like I said, a lot of times we will cook a roast not for just the meat and potatoes meal, but we'll cook it for enchiladas, we'll cook it for cabbage, we'll cook it for sandwiches. We'll cook it just to kind of pick on during the week whenever we feel like having a little snack. This is one of the simplest recipes on beerandiron.com. We cook a good roast about once or twice a week for recipes that we prepare during the week. Quick and easy recipes, just like these po' boy sandwiches. Like I said, we're going to eat like kings. So in the meantime, I want you all to enjoy. I want you all to try this recipe, and I hope it turns out great. If you got any questions, any suggestions, anything that you'd like to share with me here on beerandiron.com, feel free in the comments. I'm really wanting to know if you have a different method of cooking this way. We appreciate each and every one of you coming here to beerandiron.com, looking at our recipes, watching us cook in our kitchen. Be sure to subscribe to beerandiron.com. Click that little thumb, hit that little subscribe button, and be sure to hit that little bell so you can get updated whenever we put out a new video. There's a link to the article that's referenced in this video. If you want more information and actually the printed recipe to the beerandiron.com low and slow roast recipe, feel free to follow that link to our website and print that recipe off free of charge. No worries. I'll talk to you later. Y'all enjoy.